What's up, y'all? Coming to you with the green robe for Robe Talks. I lived in darkness for a very long time. I lived in darkness, I knew darkness, and I held on to darkness for a very long time. And what I realize now in hindsight, after doing much reflection and just walking through this journey, I realize that even in the midst of darkness, I still carried love, because I am love. I still had love. And for that, I'm grateful, because there are experiences that could have broken me to disassociate myself with love and loving myself. So even as I was in darkness and I traveled through shadows and confronted different shadows, there was a deep love within myself that I still had. However, I was operating on hate. I was operating on fear because of my experiences. Now, there are people who are unable to recognize love and believe that they cannot feel love because of their experiences, because of things that have happened. And usually that's in childhood, where that is established. If you're an adult and experience traumas, you don't necessarily lose the feeling or lose your perception of love. It may alter and shift, and as you work through that, you may come back to full circle. But usually people that believe that there is no love and believe that they have no love experience traumas in their childhood. And because you're a child, your ego will protect you by building up walls and giving you falsities for you to survive. So I grew up in darkness. I knew darkness, and I know darkness differently now. I understand that there is a duality in life and a duality in us. And not, and far beyond duality, there are so many points, so many portals. We can choose to be aware of it, choose to be present in it, choose to engage with it. These are all choices at the end of the day. In my time where I lived in darkness, I sought darkness. When I was a teenager, I would read violent books. I would watch violent films and dark films, and it did not necessarily scare me. I think because of my perception and my experiences, I viewed darkness differently. I remember there's a show called Are You Afraid of the Dark? And last night in my meditation, I decided to meditate in darkness. And as I sat in the darkness, I repeated to myself that I was born in the dark. That phrase from The Dark Knight Rises, I was born in the dark, like there's so much meaning to that. When the way that people have children now, you know, babies come into this world into this bright light that is jarring, you know, and can be traumatic. But when they're coming from a womb that was dark, but within that darkness there was love, because the mother loved the child as the child grew, as the spirit formed and took in the information. This child was still the amniotic fluid, the heartbeat, everything surrounding that child within the darkness is love. So as I sat in my room and in the darkness to meditate, I continued to chant. It was my mantra for that I was born in the dark. Every single death that I experienced, I had to go into the darkness. And it's not that I came out into the light. I am light. So even when there is darkness, I don't necessarily need to search for light, because I am light. It doesn't mean that it will illuminate everything. Okay, I think that's another idea that we tend to hold on to make us feel better. That somehow within the darkness, we still have to find light. And though it is important to acknowledge that you're a light, it is also important to acknowledge that you do not need the light in the darkness to be okay. You do not need the light in the darkness to navigate. You can also navigate in darkness. And that's by feeling. That's that heart center. that's where the heart comes into play. And I had to also recognize and connect with the fact that I gravitate towards green, not only because nature, but I've always been a loving person. And for as much as people may have tried to make me feel like I wasn't because their own issues, I had to recognize that everything that I do it in love, even the dark, okay? Even the destruction, even the tearing down and the burning, it is all in love. Love for myself. See, the choices that I make, like I said before, I make choices for myself, but also how my choices impact the souls and spirits that I have guided into this world. And in order for me to truly get an understanding of what all of that is, gotta do that shadow work. I have to be present and acknowledge all of the things that are happening. It doesn't mean that I attach myself to them, but I view what is happening and I allow it to sit. If it needs to, if it doesn't come to me right away. But thankfully, I just have clarity, okay? It's just something that I have. And I remember a friend of mine, you know, he was like, "You're very insightful." And I accept that. And I agree. I am very insightful. And that's why it is easy for me to pinpoint certain things and to recognize certain things and to decipher certain things because of this insight. And if you think about the word insight, it's within. It's in. Okay, I see from the inside, and I'm able to see what is inside of whatever is presented to me. So one of the things that I have to work on, that I had to work on, and that I continue to work on, is continuing to go within to connect with not only myself, but with everything. It is by going within that you connect with everything. You understand that we are all connected. The epiphanies come to you when you are by yourself and when you're speaking, when you're in the presence of other folks and you're speaking. One of the reasons why I think it's super important to work on that throat chakra and speaking and vocalizing and being honest with self. You know, you really want to work on these chakras. But what I found was, as I was going through my traumas, and it really does depend on each person, your personal journey will determine what you need to be working on and what order that will best maximize your healing. For me, because of my traumas, I had to work on my sacral, and I really connected with my heart. I needed that love for myself to heal my traumas, to break free and break cycles. I needed the love for myself to make choices that would best suit my children. And so I worked on my sacral chakra. I was working on that through my heart chakra, and because I'm just naturally intuitive, my mind, my third eye, whatever if you want to call it, my intuition assisted me in aligning all of these things. And part of that is going within. Part of that is walking into the darkness. Part of that is almost like embracing the darkness. I mean, at this point right now, I really do embrace the darkness because I understand its purpose. I understand the purpose of my darkness. I understand the purpose of what that does. The video that I posted, you know, transformation and change, it really is birthed through destruction and darkness. And after you pass all of that, that's when you see the light. That's when you are bloom and you blossom. But we continue to grow. You know, everything is in cycles and seasons. If we look at nature, everything moves in seasons. You know, fall and winter, things are dying. You know, the nature dies, it kills itself. And then it regenerates come spring and summer. So just like nature, we do the same thing. Life is a cycle. And there are cycles of change individually that we will continue to go through, because if we're alive and you're walking, you continue to learn. There's always going to be lessons in this life. So the lesson that I want y'all to walk away with is, we were all born in the dark. We all came from darkness. We were all born in the dark. And even in this life that we go through, those are cycles of darkness that we go through. And in order for you to really shift and change, you must recognize this and walk into the darkness. Confront the shadows, right? Shadows are seen as darkness, but we create these shadows. Whether it be our imagination, our traumas, our ego, our projections, we create shadows. The sun casts the light on you, and behind you lays your shadow. Does it mean that it is not a part of you? It is still a part of you. The sun is casting this shadow. We are suns. We are casting the shadow. So it is still a part of us. Are you afraid of your shadow? So why are you afraid of the dark? All right. I'm going to leave you guys with questions to ask yourselves, for you to answer for yourselves. It's what I tell people whenever I'm speaking with them. I'm not here to provide advice. I can share my experiences and information. But what I will always do, even with people that come to me for advice and come to speak their truths or share their stories, I pose questions and I don't need the answers. I tell people that all the time. You don't have to answer me. Here's a question. And you have to answer the questions for yourself. And it's time for people to question themselves. You don't have to wait for someone to prompt you questions. You can question yourself. That is your birthright. That is how you grow. By questioning yourself and questioning the things that are around you. Questions are good. That is how you get to answers. And sometimes you don't have to question everything. If you're trying to work through things, yes, you want to ask questions. You want to recognize certain things. But there are other times, it's just be observant. Just watch and see. What comes and goes, and things will come to you. Okay, so that's it. I gotta get back to work. As I always say, you make it a great day. It is fully within your power. And even in the dark days, you are still loved. You are still loved. You are still connected. And you are your power. It is fully within your power.